In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and most merciful. Assalamu alaikum viewers, my name is Iram Jabal. I would like to welcome you in chemistry class. In our today's lecture, we will discuss about group 3A elements and peculiar behavior of boron. First of all, we will discuss elements which are present in group 3A. Group 3A contain boron, aluminium, gallium, indium and thallium. They all are placed in group 3A because they contain three valence electrons. We can see these three valence electrons from electronic configuration of group 3A elements. If we see the periodic table, then period number of each element represent its valence shell, while the group number represent the number of valence electrons. As in case of boron, boron belongs to second period, so its valence shell is 2, and it belongs to group 3A, so it contains 3 valence electrons which are present in S and P subshell as 2s2, 2p1. Same is the case with aluminium. Aluminium belongs to third period, so its valence shell is 3. And group 3A, so it contains 3 valence electrons which are present in 3s and 3p as 3s2, 3p1. Same is the case with gallium, indium and thallium. They belong to 4, 5, 6th period. So they have 4, 5 and 6 valence shell, and again 3 valence electrons present in these subshells. Now we will discuss about the physical properties of group 3A elements. We know that size of atom increases down the group because of addition of shell in each successive member. But in case of group 3A, this increase is not regular, because when we move from top to bottom, then after aluminium, d orbital is involved. This d orbital provide poor shielding effect. Due to this poor shielding effect, nuclear force of attraction increases and size of atom not increase appreciably, as you can see from this size of group 3A. Their sizes increases, but this increase is not markable. Although size increase, but this increase is not regular, as you can see from this graph also. There is a not regular increase. As you can see this, from aluminium to gallium, there is a minor increase in size, because after aluminium, in gallium there is d orbital which provide poor shielding effect and size of atom not increases much. Now we will discuss another physical property, and we will discuss about the nature of element. In nature, we will discuss either a sub-element is a metal or non-metal. Boron is a non-metal because boron is smaller in size and have high nuclear charge, while the rest of the element of group 3A are metal due to their greater sizes. In the same way, boiling point decreases down the group because boiling point or melting point of any substance depend upon the number of bonds and binding strength. Due to increase in size, binding strength decreases, and due to same number of electrons, their binding number is same. So from top to bottom, melting point and boiling point of group 3A elements decreases. Now we will discuss another physical property, which is ionization energy. Normally, ionization energy decreases down the group, but in case of group 3A, there is some exceptional behavior, as you can see from this graph. When we move from boron to aluminium, ionization energy decreases, but after aluminium, gallium have higher ionization energy. Gallium have higher ionization energy because from aluminium to gallium, d orbital is involved. These d orbital electrons provide poor shielding effect. This poor shielding effect increases force of attraction on valence electrons, and removal of these valence electron becomes difficult. That's why gallium have higher ionization energy than that of aluminium. Same is the case with thallium. When we move from indium to thallium, then thallium again have higher ionization energy, because in thallium, beside d orbital, there is also f orbital involved. This f orbital further provide poor shielding effect. Due to poor shielding, nuclear force of attraction increases and hold on valence electron increases, which makes the removal of electron difficult. Now we will discuss electronegativity. Normally, electronegativity decreases down the group, but in group 3A, it increases. Why it increases? Electronegativity of group 3A elements increases again due to the involvement of d and f orbital. These two orbitals provide poor shielding and increases hold on electron. That's why ionized electronegativity increases from top to bottom. Now we will discuss the occurrence of group 3A elements. Boron occur in trace amount in soil and is essential element for growth of plant. Boron in nature combined with oxygen and form oxyborate and salts of polyboric acid, as you can see in this table. Boron exists in form of borates, in form of colemanite, and in form of orthoboric acids. After boron, second element is aluminium. Aluminium is the third most abundant element in Earth's crust. Aluminium is highly reactive and exists as aluminosilicate minerals in the outer portion of Earth's crust in form of feldspar, mica, colline, diaspore, emerald, and cryolite, etc. Other elements of group 3A are gallium, indium, and thallium, and they are rare and are obtained as byproduct during processing of other metals. Now we will come to the next part of our topic, which is about peculiar behavior of boron. We know that every first member of a group is different from its family members because first member have smaller size, and due to smaller size, its ionization energy is higher than rest of its members. And this first member also have greater charge density because first member have smaller size while its charge is comparatively greater. And charge density of first member is higher due to the smaller size, high ionization energy and greater charge density, boron is also different from its family members in many ways, like boron is non-metal and boron is the only element which have less than 4 electrons and still are non-metal. This is the exceptional behavior of boron, which is due to charge density of boron. Boron may use all of its 3 electrons for bonding, and when it uses 3 electrons for bonding, then it gains plus 3 or minus 3 oxidation state. It forms molecular addition compounds, but it doesn't form any compound with sulfate, nitrate or other anion, because boron doesn't form stable cation with these anions. That's why boron doesn't form any compound with these anions. It's all about today's lecture. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.